Welcome to TapRooT TV. I'm Michelle Wishon, and today I'm here with Dave Janney, who is going to talk to us about SnapChart. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you, Michelle. Happy Wednesday, everybody. Welcome to TapRooT TV. And as you know, each week we talk about a different topic, some things that we hope can help you out with using TapRooT and just in your general life, I guess. Yeah. So we're glad to be here with you.
Yes, thank you for joining us. Dave, tell us, what is SnapChart and why is it so important?
So a SnapChart is one of the tools we teach in TapRooT. And if you're a TapRooT user, you already know what a SnapChart is. So bear with us here for a minute because I'm gonna tell you why it's so important. But for those of you joining us who aren't really familiar with TapRooT, I think it would be helpful to kind of give you an idea what a SnapChart is. Now, TapRooT is world renowned for our root cause analysis process. Our root cause tree and dictionary, a lot of our corrective action tools help you really get to some good answers and some good fixes. But you can't do good root cause analysis until you have all the facts. If you remember the show Dragnet from the 1970s, for all us old folks, Joe Friday was the star of Dragnet, and one thing he used to say is just the facts, just the facts. And so one thing we really want to stress is before you get into your root cause analysis, you really have to understand what happened first. You have to do that by collecting facts, okay? And what we do is we use what's called a SnapChart to do that. So if we could put this SnapChart up on the screen, that'd be great. And I'm just gonna kind of very, very briefly tell you a little bit about what a SnapChart is, and you can see what it looks like, okay? So I'm gonna try to point to some of these shapes here, but the circle is what we're investigating. In this case, this is a major bus accident that happened in Atlanta a few years back. So it's a vehicle accident, but this could be anything. This could be an employee injury, it could be an environmental problem, it could be a quality problem, it could be an equipment reliability problem. Whatever you're trying to solve, the consequence of what happened to your business is going to go in the circle. The rectangles up on the top is your timeline, and we call these events. So it's everything leading up to the incident, and we can also have things after. Now, I've kind of condensed this a little bit. This would be more robust in real life, but I wanted to fit it on one slide.
Sure.
But so it gives you a timeline of what happened, and then all the stuff down below that I'm trying to circle here with my mouse, we call these conditions. And the conditions are all the evidence that we collect, everything about the situation we know, policy, procedure, training, equipment, environmental conditions. Just everything we learn through our investigation goes up here on the SnapChart. This becomes the basis for the rest of our analysis. TapRooT is an evidence-based process, and this is where we assemble our evidence.
Wonderful. Okay.
So that's a real quick explanation of what a SnapChart is. We're going to go ahead and take that down. And if you'd like to learn more, obviously you join us in one of our courses. But we can't have good corrective actions until we have good root causes. And we can't have good root causes until we collect really, really good information. The SnapChart is what allows us to do that.
Sure. So what tools are used to complete a SnapChart?
Well, we have a lot of tools that we teach. Everything you learn through your investigation is going to go in the SnapChart, like I said. Now, a lot of things that we teach. One of the things that's most important is we teach a concept called the three P's and the R. Mm-hmm. People, physical, paper, and recordings, okay? Mm-hmm. They're just kind of four different buckets of types of evidence you may collect. Now, recordings are great. There's security cameras everywhere these days, and it's really, really easy to investigate something if it's all on film. Mm-hmm. And I've been lucky enough to have that happen to me a few times, but honestly, we don't always have that.
Sure.
At a minimum, we probably have some pictures, though,
mm-hmm.
okay? So the R, the recordings, you may or may not have that. You usually do, but not always,
mm-hmm.
okay? But the other three, people, physical, and paper. I won't say that you have all of those 100% of the time, but I'm going to say the high 90% of the time, you have all three of those. You're always going to have physical, and you're always going to have people.
People.
Mm-hmm. You may have paper, you may not, but some of the paper types of evidence would be policies, procedures, training information, equipment inspections, just all the types of paper and records that you can review. And the good news about paper evidence is it's just really easy to collect. It's really kind of, it just takes a little bit of work and a little bit of legwork, but it's not hard, okay? The physical part is really important, and that's the part that I think a lot of times people don't do very well. They, you know, they've been to the site before, they kind of remember it, they get a phone call, they're told that something bad has happened, and they don't necessarily run out to the site. And in my opinion, that's a big mistake.
Yeah.
Because you really have to go out and look at the facility, really understand the environment that that you were in. So the physical evidence is extremely important.
Mm-hmm.
And then the last one is people. Now, this is the hardest part because you're dealing with people. People evidence is usually gathered through interviews,
mm-hmm.
okay? And the reason it's the hardest part is because interviewing really is a skill. And we have a process that we teach in our 5-day course, the TapRooT 12-step interview process. I'm not going to go too deep into that, but Barb Carr has done a number of videos on TapRooT TV and otherwise
yes.
that you can find on our YouTube channel as well as our Facebook mm-hmm. videos. She's got some great insight into our interview process, and you can also buy her book on our website. Okay,
yeah.
So I'm not going to dig too deep into that, but that's the three P's in the R.
Yes.
Okay, now we also have some other techniques that are great. We call these optional techniques in TapRooT, where the snap chart is a mandatory technique. We have some optional techniques to help you collect evidence. One of them is called Equifactor. Equifactor is for equipment troubleshooting. So if you need a little bit of help collecting equipment information, you're trying to understand really the physical cause of the failure before you do your root cause analysis, that's where Equifactor comes in. Now, Ken Reed did a video on Equifactor from last week. So if that sounds like something that would interest you, I'm not going to go too deep into Equifactor today, but we have that great video from last week. So again, check out our different resources and you can find Ken's video from last week.
Yes.
Okay, so that's Equifactor. The next one is called CHAP, Critical Human Action Profile. What CHAP allows you to do is map out a task to really understand how it's supposed to work and then make a comparison between how it's supposed to work and how it did work. So, you know, most of us aren't really trained human performance experts, and mapping it out and really trying to understand the process and what took place really helps you gather information and understand what went wrong, okay? So sometimes what it will reveal is what the person did wrong, okay? Which is what we're trying to do.
Yes.
Sometimes what a CHAP will reveal is that you actually do have a very good process in place, or it may reveal that your process is broken. So CHAP really works a couple different ways. And so when you can't understand human error, CHAP is the way to go many times. But it also helps you prove that your process is good or maybe it needs some improvement.
Yes.
Okay. So that's CHAP. Now the last one is actually my favorite. It's called change analysis.
Mm-hmm.
And change analysis helps us compare reliable situations with unreliable situations. For example, let's say you had a site at your company. It did really well for a long period of time, 10 years, no injuries, but in the last few months, you've had several injuries. Well, the question that would come to my mind right now is, what has changed in this last 6 months?
Sure.
And it's a really effective interviewing technique, actually. You can go out, we call this simplified change analysis. You go out and you talk to the employees and you say, what has changed in the last 6 months? They're the ones that know, they're the ones that are there. And so that's a really effective interviewing technique, but also for yourself to kind of think about what's changed or what's different in the environment.
Mm-hmm.
But we actually have a formal process that we teach you in the 5-day course to go through and really map out what all the factors are that could influence the successful performance of the job. And it helps us understand where things went wrong. And all three of these techniques are very helpful to get you pieces of information, but always remember, the purpose of these techniques is to gather information, which ends up ultimately on your snap chart.
Yes, change analysis is also one of my favorites.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. It's great. You can use it for equipment
mm-hmm.
or for people.
Yes, yeah. So, well, great. Thank you so much, Dave. If you want more information, you can visit us at our website at www.taproot.com. You can also find us on all social media platforms. Have a safe week, and we'll see you next Wednesday at noon Eastern.
Thank you. See you next Wednesday. Take care.